Here is the video clip for Roman numerals, the last topic of chapter 1. Few important Roman numbers are highlighted here. You all have to note it down in your maths copy. Then, the rules for the system are. Downside, I have mentioned few rules. Following those rules, we have to solve the Roman numerals. One by one, I'll explain all the rules. Then, the questions you have to do on your own. The first rule is here. You see, if a symbol is repeated, its value is added as many times it occurs. This rule says that any symbol, when it is written again and again, when it is written more than once, so its value is added within itself. If suppose I am repeating x 2 times, so what is the value of x? X's value is 10 in Roman number. I told you, when it is repeated, then its value will be added within it. This is 10. When 10 is added with this number, become 20. Got it? Same if I write here this symbol, only 1. I mean, one straight line denotes 1. When I make it here, two lines together make up 2. When one more, I'll do a line, it becomes 3. So, first rule, I hope it is clear. Whatever symbol is repeated, its value is added to itself. The value of x is 10. How many times we will write x? 10 will be added that many times. First point is clear. Then, I'll tell you the next rule. You see, a symbol is not repeated more than 3 times. Mark this point very carefully. No symbol is repeated more than 3 times. We cannot repeat it more than thrice. Suppose I am writing here C. You know, C means 100. Okay. So if I write here one more C, it will become 100 plus 100, 200. One more will become 300. Is it possible to write here 4 times C? Not at all. That's why I told you, no symbol can be repeated more than 3 times. Keep in mind. Got it, na? Then, symbol V, L and D. What does this V means? Refers to 5, you can see here. Then L refers to 50 and D means 500, you can see. So these symbols, which are V, L and D, these three symbols can never be written more than once. We can write V only for 5, L only for 50 and D only for 500. We cannot write these for more than one time. Suppose we cannot write V and V, it will be called as 10. Not at all. Got it clear this point? So that's why I have written here, these symbols cannot be repeated. And a symbol can be repeated only 3 times. So first and second rule, I suppose it is clear. Then, we'll come to the third one. See, if a symbol of a smaller value, what does this mean? Any symbol which is having a small value, suppose I, all these symbols are having a smaller value, na? So, this symbol, when it is written to the right side of greater value, what does this mean? Greater value? Suppose I have written here 5. So 5 is the greater value, na? If I am writing I, which is smaller than this, to the right side. Are you getting my point or not? This 5 is having a greater value and this is having a smaller value. Whenever we write the smaller value number right side of the bigger value number, that time that smaller value is added to this bigger value. What does this mean? 5 plus 1. Got it, na? So keep in mind, when a smaller value is written right side to the greater value, its value is added. Understood? Suppose I am writing a greater value, which is L. L is the greater value, right? Now, any smaller value than L means anything which is less than L. So what could be less than L? V is less than L, I is less than L, X is less than L. All these are less, na? So anything. Suppose I'm writing here V. So what does this V will do? This V will be added to this L, means 50 plus 5, 55. Is it clear to you? So this was your third rule. What is the third rule? Any smaller value right side of the greater value will be added to that value. I'll show you with the example here. You can see 3 examples I have written for rule third. You can see here L. What does this L means? 50. You see, now this is the greater value. If I have written the smaller value here, its value is added within this. Then again 5. It is also smaller. Again it is added. Then you can see 10. It is the bigger value. When I add the less number, smaller number with this, it will be added. So third rule is clear, means whenever the smaller number is to the right side, it is added in that number. Now we'll come to rule number D. You see, if a symbol a smaller value is to the left of the symbol of greater value. Now, this point you see, when a smaller symbol is written to the left side of the greater symbol, what does this mean? You see here, suppose X is greater number. Now, what are a smaller number than X? V is a smaller number. I is a smaller number. Yes or no? So when I write the smaller number left side of X, when I write the smaller number left side, when smaller number is left to the greater number, it is always subtracted from that number. Means X minus 1, it will be considered as 9. Understood? Suppose D is known as 500. Now C is known as 100. C is smaller than this or not? Definitely this is smaller. So when a smaller number is written to the left side, what does this mean? This smaller number will be subtracted from this greater number. So this rule says that any smaller number, when written left side of the greatest number, it is always subtracted from that number. You can see here, I have written X, then left side 1 means X minus 1. You see here, C is bigger number. When this number is having a small number left side, it is subtracted from that number. Very important point now. These points you see, symbol V, L and D are never written to the left side of a small symbol of greater value. Always keep in mind, suppose I am writing here X. Now you will say that, ma'am, 5 is also smaller. Yes, na? Then X minus 5, it will be 5. Not at all. Okay. What does this mean? That these symbols V, L and D, these three symbols are never written to the left side of the bigger number. Any number which is bigger, we cannot write these three numbers to the left side, always keep in mind. You got it clear, na? So it can be asked in your exams also. Which are those symbols which cannot be written to the left side? So what are those symbols which cannot be written to the left side? Those symbols are V, L and D. I mean to say that these symbols we cannot rewrite to the left side. We cannot subtract these symbols. Understood, na? So we studied the five rules till now. Now next one. I'll tell you two important notes. You note down these. Very important part this is. Symbol I can be subtracted only from V and X. Okay. Means I. I is 1, na? So 1 can only be subtracted from V and X. That this means that 1 cannot be written before C. 1 cannot be written before before D. These all things are wrong. This means that 1 only can be written before V. 1 only can be written before X. Okay, only these two times. First note is done. Then next one, the symbol X can be subtracted only from L, M and C. Keep in mind, very important part this is. Symbol X can only be written left of the L, M and C. X cannot be written backside of I or like that. Okay. X only can be written L, M and C. These two notes also are done. All these rules which I told you now. Once you go through all notes again and then we'll do the Roman number solutions. You see here, once a small recap we'll do. Roman number, here are important Roman numbers, always to be kept in mind. The five rules, five general rules for Roman numbers. You may note down all the rules. All the rules should be noted down in your copy, all of you. You see, first rule, what was that? Symbol is repeated, its value is added. Whenever we repeat the symbol, its value gets added towards that symbol. Then second rule was, symbol is not repeated more than 3 times. Very important point. Any symbol we cannot repeat more than thrice. Only which symbol cannot be, and 3 symbols which can never be repeated. We cannot repeat it any time. Those are V, L and D. These symbols we cannot repeat once also. Then whenever we write any symbol to the right side, its value get added within it. When we write to the right sides, its value gets added. And next one, if a symbol is written to the left, its value gets subtracted. Okay, its value gets subtracted. Few symbols which can never be written on the left side, which are they? V, L and D. These three symbols we cannot write towards the left side. Then note, we'll come to I can only be subtracted from V and 10, and X can only be subtracted from L, M and C. Okay, so these Roman number notes you have to write in your copy. After noting down the rules, you have to solve all these Roman numbers in your copy. You may note down, write in Roman numerals. I have already told you the rules. Using those rules, you have to solve these Roman numbers. Note down somewhere and you have to solve it. I'll turn the page. Few more I have written here. Write in Roman numerals. These are the questions which you have to solve. This is all about the Roman numerals. Got it clear?